Happy morning students. I am happy to meet you once again through this online videos. Today these online classes are very inevitable. I am going to discuss through these classes the periodic classification of elements part 2. Okay, already we finished part 1. This is the existence of part 1. Okay, we are going to see, we go to lesson nomenclature of element with atomic number greater than 100. In this session we will discuss about two topics. One is nomenclature of element, another one is electronic configuration of element. Okay, this is the main topic. These are the main topics we are going to discuss. First one, nomenclature of element. Why we need a nomenclature of element atomic number greater than 100? Because the naming of a new element had been traditionally the privilege of the discoverer, and suggested name was ratified by the IUPAC. In recent years, this has led to some controversy. The new elements with very high atomic numbers are so unstable that only minute quantities also, sometimes only a few atoms of them are obtained. Their synthesis and characterization therefore require highly sophisticated and costly equipment and a laboratory. Such work is carried out with a competitive spirit only in some laboratories in the world. Okay, so this first stanza, what it describes, what it explains. Okay, why we need IUPAC? Because it is a high atomic number also unstable, and that only minute quantities, sometimes only a few atoms of them are obtained, and it requires a high cost and laboratory it requires. Okay, and also before collecting the reliable data on the new element, the scientists, many scientists, okay, they are trying to discover one element in that process, before collecting the reliable data on new element, at times get tempted to claim for its discovery. They are tempted to claim for its discovery. I am only first discovered. I am only first. So many scientists so there is a competition between the scientists. Due to that, for example, both American and Soviet scientists claimed credit for discovering element 104. Okay, both the scientists, American scientists and also what Soviet scientists, who discovered at the same time the element 104. The element 104, atomic number is 104. The Americans named it Rutherfordium, whereas Soviets named it Kurchatovium. Okay, Kurchatovium. To avoid such problems, the IUPAC or IUPAC has made recommendation that until a new element discovery is proved and its name is officially recognized, a systematic nomenclature be derived directly from the atomic number of the element using the numerical roots. The IUPAC recommended that to avoid the controversial talks between the scientists and so many scientists discovered the same element, they are fighting with each other. Okay, that's why, to avoid this controversy, whenever who discovered first, okay, then IUPAC recommended rules. Okay, what are the rules? That introduced that rule is numerical roots for 0 and numbers 1 to 9. Numerical root word they introduced. These are shown in the table. In the next slide we will see. Okay, that's why we need a nomenclature of element. Because now why we need a nomenclature? Because it's in, the element is named in discoverer name. At the same time so many scientists were trying to discover the same element. okay, it makes a controversial and it makes fight between the scientists. That's why the IUPAC recommended one rule or one set of rules they recommended. That is called as a numerical roots. We are going to see that one also. Okay, see this. Okay, that is notation for IUPAC, IUPAC, nomenclature of element. See that digit 0, name is nil. That's a recommended, IUPAC recommended that. Okay, abbreviation is N. 0 means N. Whenever above greater than 0, 100, 101, 102, whenever the element atomic number is greater than 0, we follow this IUPAC recommended rules. That is the root word rules. Okay, that is 0 means nil. Abbreviation is N. Okay, then digit 1 means un, then abbreviation is U. Like that 2 means by, abbreviation is B. Okay, like that 9 means N, E, double N. Okay, then abbreviation is E. Octa means 8 means oct, abbreviation is, first letter is named as a abbreviation. Okay, then see this nomenclature of elements with atomic number above 100. Nomenclature of element with atomic number above 100. For 101 means, 1 means what? An. Now only I said, okay, in last slide. 101 means, 1 means an, 0 means nil, then 1 means an. At commonly the IUPAC recommended that whenever we discover the any element greater than 0, okay, before the confirmation the element should be ended with the EM is commonly the element's name is should be ended with the EM, which means unnil unEM. Okay, then 102 means unnil un, 0 means nil, 1 means un, 2 means by, so ended with the EM, unnil BM. Okay, then 103 means unnil, 3 means tri, at the suffix always ended with the EM. Okay, unnil trium, okay, quartium, then unnil pentium, unnil hexium, unnil septium, unnil octium, unnil N nium. Okay, unnil N nium, unnil, next one unnil 110 means unnil unnil, sorry, unnan 1111 unnan, 0 means il. Okay, em. Okay, nil em. Okay, that's a rule. Okay, now then Mendelevium, okay, which is 101, this later it is discovered. Then officially IUPAC revealed that what is it? 101 means Mendelevium, 101 means Mendelevium. It is a one unknown means that 101 U, symbol is UNU, that is called a, it's a, that symbol is named as a what? It's a temporary one. Okay, after we discovered, someone discovered that, it is named by that scientist name. Okay, but before the reliable data is given by the scientist who discovered that element, that temporary name is we followed. Okay, here see that bottom of the table, official IUPAC name yet to be announced means star indicated what in this table, official IUPAC name yet to be announced, which means under process the discovery of element is going on. Okay, under process. Next one, plus means element yet to be discovered, it's all going to discover. That's why we use the temporary name. Okay, temporary name is based on the IUPAC recommended set of rules. Okay, so next one, the example. Okay, can you give the symbol for 120? That's a question. What would be the IUPAC name and symbol for atomic number 120? 120, 1 means what? 1 means un, 2 means by, 0 means nil, un by, 0 means what? 0 means nil, then at the suffix what we add? Em, commonly we add em. Okay, that's why un by nil em, when we say name it un by nil em. The 120 means what would be the IUPAC name? 1 by nillium is IUPAC name, would be the unnil by M. Then electronic configuration of element and periodic table. First topic I finished. Okay, mainly we are going to see, I said two topics. One is electronic configuration, another one is nomenclature. Nomenclature I finished. Next one is electronic configuration of elements. Here electronic configuration, in the preceding unit we have learnt that an electron in an atom is characterized by a set of four quantum number. That quantum number we will see in second lesson. Okay, we are discussing third lesson actually. We will see in a second lesson. The four quantum number, what are the namely we may study in 10th also. What are that four quantum number? Principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number, spin quantum number. Okay, here we use only principal quantum number. Okay, we will see in second lesson all the quantum number elaborately. Okay, then principal quantum number is, symbol is N, azimuthal L, magnetic M, spin is small letter. Okay, spin quantum number is S. Here N, principal quantum number, defines the main energy level known as cell. What is the role of the principal quantum number? It only telling about or only speaking about the main energy level, that is named as a cell. Okay, then we have also studied about the filling of electron into different subcell. We have studied also about that's the second lesson, I think that's a second lesson, but we are discussing third lesson. We will see in that, okay, elaborately. Here it requires some introduction to that. That's why I am discussing about this. Okay, we have also studied about filling of electron into different subcell, also referred to as orbitals, sp, df in an atom. The distribution of electron into orbital of an atom is called electronic configuration. What is electronic configuration? The distribution of electron into orbital of an atom. In atom, how electrons are filled in the orbital, that is called as the electronic configuration. What are the rule we are using to fill the electronic configuration? Okay, we will see that also. Okay, what are the rules? You may study in 10th also, alpha principle, Hund's rule, Hund's maximum multiplicity rules, Hund's maximum multiplicity, and what? That's the third one is a what? Pauling exclusion principle. Pauli exclusion principle. These are the rule we are mainly used to fill the electron in the orbital of an atom. Next one, electronic configuration. Okay, electronic configuration in period. What is period? That's a horizontal rows of the periodic table is modern periodic table is called. Modern periodic table is introduced by whom? Discovered by whom? On the basis of what? Atomic mass or atomic number? We study last class. Atomic number. Okay, that is introduced by Henry Moseley. Okay, see this. The horizontal rows are called period. The vertical columns are called groups. Here electronic configuration in period. How many periods in modern periodic table? Is we already discussed in the last topic also, seven period. Okay, in first period, what is the first element of the first period? Hydrogen and helium. First period is start with the hydrogen, end with the helium. How many element is present? Two element is present. But how many orbital for first period? How many orbital? Only 1s. 1s 1 means hydrogen, 1s 2 means helium. 1s 2 means helium. The only orbital is 1s. Okay, only one orbital. So 1s mean hydrogen means one electron filled in that 1s orbital. Helium means two electron filled in the same hot orbital, 1s orbital. For that, here in first period, how many element? Two element. But how many orbital? How many orbital? One orbital. Okay, in first period, two element. How many orbital? One orbital. Which means what? The elements is twice that of orbital. In each period, the element is twice that of orbital. That's the point. In each period, the element is twice that of orbital. See this? I read out. Okay, I'm going to read. The period indicates the value of N for the outermost or valence cell. Period means what? It indicates what? Outermost or valence cell. Okay, for example, 1s. 1 is a cell. Outermost cell or valence cell. For hydrogen, which one is a valence cell? 1 is a valence cell. Okay, here see this. In other words, successive period in the periodic table is associated with the filling of the next higher principal energy level. N is equal to 1, N is equal to, the electrons are filled to what? Higher levels, principal energy, that is called cell. Okay, N is equal to 1, N is equal to 2s, 2, P3s, 3, P3d, 4s. Okay, that's the enter into the successive energy levels. The number of elements in each period is, I said, twice the number of orbital, atomic orbital available in energy level that is being filled. Number of elements in the period is twice that of atomic orbital. Okay, the first period, for example, I am going to explain the example. First period, n, what is the first period mean? What is the principal quantum number? Symbol n is equal to 1. Start with the filling of lowest level is 1s. Okay, lowest level 1s. And the therefore the has two elements, hydrogen and helium. Hydrogen and helium, because only one orbital, 1s orbital. That's why how many elements are possible? Twice that of orbital, atomic orbital, that's why 2. Okay, 1s 1, 1s 2. Next, that is called K cell. That is otherwise first cell is n is equal to 1 means what cell? It is an English letter we used is not K cell. Next one is L cell. Second cell n is equal to 2 means L cell. In L cell, how many, what is the second, in the second period, which is the first element? Okay, do you know? You may know from 10th standard and 9th standard also. Okay, then the second element see this, in the second period n is equal to 2, start with the lithium and the third electron enters the 2s orbital. Third electron enters to 2s because lithium. Okay, 1s 2 finished and 2s 1, third electron to second cell. S is a subcell. S is a subcell. Okay, second cell 2s 1. The next element, beryllium, has 4 electrons and has 3 electronic configuration, and has the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2. For beryllium, 1s2, 2s2. For lithium, 1s2, 2s1, 1s2, 2s1. Next one is starting from the next element, boron. Next one we go to P block, boron in the same period, second n is equal to 2 only. Boron to 2p orbital are filled with the electron when the L cell is completed at the neon. Second period is end with the neon. Okay, helium. First period is end with the start with the hydrogen, end with the helium. Second period is start with the sodium, end with the neon. Okay, and neon, the outer electronic configuration will be 2s2 2p6. 2s2 2p6. 2p6 mean how total number of orbital for a second period is, for s, one orbital. Okay, one orbital, because lithium and beryllium. Okay, lithium and beryllium, which means only one orbital it can accommodate 2 electron. Okay, one orbital p, in p there is a 6 element is present, mean how many orbital? 3 element, because it is twice the top. Okay, I said twice that. Okay, then 3 orbital here, 1 orbital, 4 orbital. Total number of element is twice, 2 into 4, total number of element is 8. In second, that is a question, in second period how many element is present? In second period how many element is present? Because 4 orbital is involved, that's why 8 element is present. Okay, next one, third period. Okay, next one we are going to see third period. In third period, n is equal to, what is the value, n value third period? 3. Third period 3 means it start with the sodium and the order electron enters the 3s orbital and the successive filling of 3s and 3p orbital give rise to the third period of element from sodium to argon. Here also what? Third period also what? How many elements? Okay, because 8 element, because 4 orbital only. Okay, that's why here also. Then it's fourth period n is equal to 4. It starts with the, where it starts, potassium. Okay, it starts with the potassium and the order electron fill up the 4s orbital. Fourth period, 4s orbital. Next one, now you may note that before the 4p orbital is filled, filling up of 3d orbital is involved. Okay, before 4p, in the fourth period, before the filling of 4p orbital, 3d orbital is involved. Okay, but the, why 3d orbital is involved? Because I am reading this, because filling up of 3d orbital becomes energetically favorable and we come across the so called 3d transition series of element. Okay, in the fourth period 3d element is 3d block element is starts. Even it is considered as the electrons are entered in which cell? Third cell, 3d. Okay, third cell, in third cell, in which subcell? D subcell. Okay, in fourth period d block element is started in fourth period, but d block elements entered in which cell? Third cell, 3d. That's why, because energetically available. Okay, third cell is energetically available, that's why in electrons are, d electrons are entered in which cell? Third cell. Okay, that's the point. That's why the general electronic configuration, we will see that general electronic configuration is n minus 1. What is the n value for a fourth period? n is equal to 4. Then n minus 1, general formula for d block element is n minus 1. N minus 1 means 4 minus 1. Then electron will enter into which cell? Third cell. For fifth period, electron will n which cell? Electron will enter in which cell? Fifth period, n minus 1 means 5 minus 1, 4. So the electron will enter into fourth cell. Okay, see this. This start from scandium. Scandium here is only fourth period. Only scandium is started. Okay, to starts scandium atomic number is Z means symbol. Atomic number symbol is Z. Mass number symbol is capital A. Okay, then 21, which has the electronic configuration 3d1 4s2. For scandium outer electronic configuration is 3d1 4s2. Okay, next one. 3d orbitals are filled up to zinc, up to it go end with the zinc, then only it start with the p block element, then only it start with the p block element. The fourth period end up to the krypton. The fourth period end up to the first period helium, second period neon, third period in argon, fourth period is krypton. Okay, then total number of element, can you explain total number of element in the fourth period? Okay, n is equal to 4 means 4s is possible. 4s, okay, 1 orbital, s 1 orbital. Then 4p is possible. Then 4p, okay, 4 minus 1 for d element, d orbital is involved in fourth period. 4 minus 1, 3. Okay, 3d. For d subcell, how many orbitals are possible? How many orbitals are possible? 5. Then 5 orbital plus 1 s 1 orbital. Then in p orbital, 3 orbital, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. Total number of orbital is 9, means total number of element in the period is twice that of. Then 2 into 9, how many elements? 18 elements. In the fourth period, how many elements? In the fifth period also, that's one of the question. Okay, fifth period also, how many element? Okay, that's what I am going to discuss next one. In fifth period, it beginning with the rubidium. Okay, similar to the fourth period. Okay, there are also how many element? 18 element. Okay, next one. In sixth period, here one interesting one. Sixth period, n value is 6, which contains 32 elements and successive elements. Electrons enter the 6s, 4f, 5d and 6p. Okay, in order of filling of electron, 4p, 4f orbital begins with the cerium. Here only 4f orbital is involved in a sixth period part. The electron filled into s orbital, okay, s orbital. Then it reaches to not d orbital. Here between the s orbital and d orbital, there is a f orbital. F subcell is introduced. Okay, that's why it. But properties of the f orbital element, properties of that 14 elements are not similar to d block element. Its properties are dissimilar with the d block element. That's why. That is a main two reason to why f block elements are placed under the periodic table. The main two reason is, one is to avoid the structure. Another one is f block elements have a dissimilar properties with the d block element. Okay, many of the properties are dissimilar with the d block element. That's why dissimilar properties never arranged in the same block. That's why it placed in the, that's one of the important question. That's why it is placed in the under the periodic table. Okay, that is the sixth period. Then 4f is started. Why 4f? Sixth period mean I expecting 6f, but general formula is n minus 2. Okay, n minus 2 means 6 minus 2, 4f. The electron only energetically available in 4f orbital. Fourth cell in f orbital, electron will enter. Okay, next one, seventh period also like that, like a sixth period, like a sixth period. Okay, actinium here also in sixth period. Lanthanum to lutetium, it's a 4f block. Okay, and then actinium to lawrencium, 5f block. Actinium to lawrencium, 5f. Actinium atomic number is here 89. Okay, then actinium is 89, gives the 5f inner transition series, known as actinium. It is called inner transition series. D block elements are called transition theory because transition is available. Transition, okay, in here transition available. That's why, because vacant or whenever a metal atom or its ion can, whenever it has a vacant orbital in its d subcell, there is a transition is possible. That's why it is called as a transition element. transition element, but it is placed the in the transition elements are Langerhans and Hawkings are called in the transition element. Why? Because it is placed inner part of the transition element, that's why it is called inner transition element. The 4F and 5F inner transition series of elements are placed separately in periodic table to maintain its structure. I said already, to maintain the structure and also preserve the principle of classification by keeping elements with similar properties in a single column. In a single column, okay, same properties element always should be in single column or separate place. Okay, next one, how would you justify the presence of 18 element in the fifth period of the periodic table? How would you justify 18 element in fifth period? How many elements? 18 element, because 9 orbital means 9 into 2 18. Okay, 9 orbital only involved means 9 into 2 18. Okay, we can easily justify that. That's the question. Okay, that's all asked in this question. The total number of orbital available are 9. That's why 18 elements, okay, fifth period. We see this next one. Group wise electronic configuration. I explained period wise electronic configuration. Next one, group wise electronic configuration. What are the groups, what are the blocks in periodic table? Okay, how many groups in periodic table? First, how many groups in periodic table? The vertical columns are called the groups, okay. 18 groups in modern periodic table, 18 groups, okay. In modern periodic table, how many periods? How many periods? 7 periods. Now only I discuss. Okay, now only I talk about that. Next one, group wise electronic configuration. The elements in the same vertical column or group have similar valence shell electronic configuration. The number of electron in the outer orbital and similar properties. Number of electron in outer orbitals are same and similar properties. Valence electronic configuration also same. Outer orbital having same number of electron and it has that's why it has similar property. Based on that only we classified the block, 4 block. Based on that only we classified the periodic element in 4 blocks. We are going to discuss next one. For example, group 1. In group 1 is what is that? Group 1 alkali metal. Group 2 alkaline earth metal. Okay, alkali metal, alkaline earth metal. We will see elaborately alkali and alkaline earth metal. What is alkali? What is alkaline earth? What is the meaning? We will see. Here only I am talking about an overview of the periodic table. Overview of the periodic table. Okay, we have separate lessons to speak about that. What is alkali? What is transition? What p block element? We will see that. Electronic configuration and type of element. Based on the electronic configuration, we classify into 4 types. The periodic table is classified into 4 blocks. One is S block, P block, D block, F block. Okay, how many blocks? 4 blocks. You see this? See this periodic table? Okay, it's a modern periodic table. Hydrogen is placed in S block element. Okay. In for older periodic table, it is placed in middle of the periodic table, but nowadays it is placed in S block, because many properties are similar to S block element. That's why it is placed in under S block element. See this, how many period, how many blocks? S block, P block, T block, F block. Okay, where the first hydrogen first period, N is equal to 1 means hydrogen to helium. Next one, lithium to neon. Second, N is equal to 3 means sodium to argon. Okay, we memorize all the element. Okay, for example, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc, yttrium, zirconium, niobium, molybdenum, technetium, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver, cadmium. It's like you have to memorize that. Okay, all the elements in the periodic table, it is very very vital. Okay, it is also inevitable whenever we are reading about a periodic classification. We need to memorize the periodic table. Okay, first group, hydrogen, end with the francium. Second group, beryllium, and end with it's a metal. All the S block elements are metals. For soft metal, but it's a readily reactive, more reactive soft metal. Okay, more reactive soft metal. Whenever we are okay, more reactive and soft metal. Its oxidative state is general. I am giving overview. Okay, its oxidative state is only 1+1 for alkali metal, +1 for alkaline earth metal, +2 only. But in the P block element, it has a variable oxidative state. Here only all metal, but there
metal is there, non-metal is there, and metalloids. Metalloids between the metal and non-metal is called metalloids. There also, okay, boron, silicon, germanium, that like arsenic, and then we will discuss that also in this topic, okay, here. But D block all are metal. F block is also metal. Inner transition metal. See this next one. S block 11. I classified separate blocks. Okay, S block 11. How many elements you know? You count that. How many elements present in S block 11? What is outer electronic configuration for S block 11? NS1. For first two group, what is the general outer electronic configuration? NS1. N means cell. Okay. For hydrogen 1s1, for sodium 1s2, 2s1, okay, N means outer cell or valence cell, okay, then beryllium means 4 means 1s2, 2s2, outer electronic configuration 2s2, what is general oxide state plus 1 and alkaline earth metal is plus 2, okay, second group is plus 2. Next to see this next one, giving the information, the elements of group 1 alkaline metals and group 2 alkaline earth metals, okay, which have a NS1 and NS2 outermost electronic configuration belong to the S block 11, okay. NS1 means alkaline metal, NS2 means alkaline earth metal. They are all reactive metal with low ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy low means highly reactive metals, okay. That's why all are sodium is always in the form of oxide, not free element is not possible. Sodium oxide, lithium oxide, lithium hydride, it's hydride, any of form, because highly reactive in nature, okay, that's why it is in earth, present in earth crust, acid, oxide or hydride, any of the compound form. Next one, P block 11, okay, which group is P block 11? 13 to 18, okay, what is the, see the color, different colors, okay, aluminium, gallium, indium, titanium, and tin, lead, bismuth, polonium, they are called metal. In P block element, some are metal. The green color are called metalloids. Between the metal and non-metal. What are non-metal? Carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, these are called non-metal. Non-metal also, some are gases. Okay, chlorine is gas, neon is gas, and oxygen, nitrogen, some are gas. Some are non-metal but solid. Some are liquid also. Bromine is a liquid at room temperature. Some metals are but non-metal. Okay. Next one. One more question is non-metal. The noble gas is the only gas which is present in monoatomic form. Other gases are diatomic or polyatomic. But this one is monoatomic. Helium only. It is not helium 2. Helium. Neon only. Not neon 2 molecule. Okay. It is because already stable. Not possible to produce Ne2, okay, that's why. So one more question, next one, that's the explanation about that. They are collectively called as a S block and P block element is collectively called as a representative element or main group element. Total number of element is how many? 36 P block element in the periodic table. How many P block element? 36. What is general electronic configuration? NS2, important one. NS2 NP126. 1 means boron family, 2 means carbon family, okay, 2 means carbon family, 3 means nitrogen family, NP3 means nitrogen family, okay. See this next one, the D block element, where it start? 3D series mean which period it start? 4th period, N is equal to 4, but for general formula is N minus 1, that's why it is called 3D series. How many series? 3D series, 4D series, 5D, 6D. In 5D series, which transition, inner transition is involved, inner transition means lanthanum to lutetium, 4F block, then actinium to laurentium, that is called a 5F block, okay, let's see this, D block elements also called transition element, the general electronic configuration, N-1, N-1, D-1-2, 1 means scandium, 10 means zinc, and NS-0-2, NS-2 must be NS 0 to, that is not 0 to 2, the NS 1 to 2 only is correct, only 1 to 2 is correct, they mistakenly they indicated, okay, NS 1 to 2. Next one is, they are metal, all the D block iron, all the metal iron and cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc, all the metals are present here. Zinc, cadmium is important one, zinc, cadmium, mercury, which you have The electronic configuration n minus 1 d10 ns2 do not show most of the properties of trans element. Why for most of the property trans element? Because it's ionic form also. There is no transition possible because d orbital always fully filled. D orbital fully filled means they are not able to show the transition. Okay, that's why it is called a, okay, it is not depend on the properties. It is not considered as a d Black element because no transition is possible because all the orbit d orbitals are fully or completely filled. Okay, next one, f Black element. See this f Black element, which period is started? Sixth period, but block is 4 up because electron enter to n minus 2 means 6 minus 2 4, that's why 4 up block. Next one is 5 up block. Okay, you memorize that. Next one, F block elements are called, otherwise called inner transition. What is general electronic configuration? N minus 2 F 1 to 14. Okay, 1 means cerium, 14 means what? Lutetium in for lanthanide series. Okay, N minus 1 D 0 or 1. N minus 1 0 or 1. Next one, NS2. NS2 NS2 is compulsory. Sixth period, 6S is filled must. Should be 6S should be must filled. Then only go to what, 4 block element and 5D. Okay, 5D because N minus 1. They are metal. Here also 14 element first series. Cerium 58, lutetium 71 are called lanthanides. They are called lanthanides. Okay, they are called also called rare earth metal. They are otherwise called as a rare earth because mostly it is not, it is only synthetically discovered. That is, otherwise it is called as a trans uranium element. The elements after uranium are called trans uranium. Next to the uranium, all the elements are trans uranium. Okay, next one, example. See the example, the elements. Okay, what you learnt, what you listen, you have some question, example question. The element Z is equal to 117 and 120. 117 atomic number. Z mean atomic number. Have not yet been discovered. Not yet been discovered till now. Okay. If I take it as that is a question. In which family or group would you place these elements and also give the electronic configuration of each case? If 117 is one of the element not yet to be discovered, once it is discovered means which should be the suitable position, which period and which group, that is a question. See this answer. In the periodic table, the element with the atomic number 117 means would belong to the halogen family. Why it's belong to the halogen? See this thing. Okay, because and the electronic configuration would be radon 5F14. Okay, so we filled 14 element filled, 60 10 also filled, 7s2 7p5. It should be 7s2 7p because seventh period is incomplete period. Okay, so incomplete halogen family, it placed in 116 up to 116 we knew. 117 means if I discovered mean next to in the halogen family. 118 means what? In noble family. 118 noble. Then 119 means what? It comes to, yeah, according to alpha opens, it comes to S block element. 109 means S block element, first group alkali metal. Then 120 means, that is a question. 120 means P block, sorry, S block element in alkaline earth metal. That's the answer. Alkaline earth metal, and we'll have the electronic configuration UUO. Why UUO? 1 means UN. 1 2 0. 2 means by. Oh, it's mistakenly they indicated U. U 1 2 means B, U B. Okay, 0 means nil. U B N M. Okay, that is called UUO. Okay, UUO 8S2. 8S2 because 8S2 it end with the 8S2. Sorry, one minute. 118 means 118 118 is a noble gas, it's not discovered. If it discovered means U means 1. Then 118 for 118, 1 means un, and another one un. 8 means oct. Oct means O, symbol is O. The next last noble gas of the 7th period. Last noble gas of the last, it is not discovered, that's why we use a temporary symbol. Next one, metal and non-metal. I said metal, which are metal? Alkali metal, alkaline earth metal, trans metal. Okay, 70% of elements are metal in periodic table. All the S block element, D block element, A block elements are metal only. S, P, D all are metal. S block is trans is D block is trans is metal. S block is metal, alkali metal and alkaline earth metal, soft metals. Okay, A block also inner transition metal. D block, P block only metal, non-metal and metalloids. Okay, that's the metallic character increases down the group and increasing along the period we move from left to right. Down the group metallic, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Which one is more metallic character? Down the group only metallic character increases. That's why whenever we are moving from left to right in the periodic table, which means period. Now moving from period, group metallic character increases in the period. Metallic character decreases. That's why nitrogen is gas, oxygen is gas, fluorine is gas, and neon is noble gas. Okay, next one, non-metal. Some example now for non-metal, 18 are non-metal, hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur, selenium, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, and UUO. UUO means 118. Okay, it's not discovered, not yet to be discovered. Okay, the non-metallic character increases as one goes from left to right across the periodic table, non-metallic character. Okay, then metalloids. Metalloids mean between the metal and the non-metal, that is called the metalloids. What are they? Silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, polonium, astatine. They are called metalloids or semi-metals. See this. Okay, some example they are giving, some example you work out this. Okay, because which one is more metal based on this, which position the element is located in the periodic table, you have to know this. Okay, that's why I said you have to memorize the periodic table in. Okay, S block means you memorize vertically, or P block also vertically, D block horizontally, F block also horizontally. Okay, see this, you work out this. If you don't mean know means you ask me. Okay, finally we finished two topics of the periodic classification. One is a nomenclature and the another one is a electronic configuration among period and also group, and what is the nature of the what are the blocks involved in the periodic table. Okay, what are the blocks? S block, P block, D block, F block. Okay, what are the general overview? Okay, general properties overview for the S block. S block means, or S block can be classified into 1s, ns1, ns2. ns1 means lithium hydrogen family, ns2 means beryllium family. Okay, borons. Okay, boron is a 13th group, in between the second group and 13th group, how many groups are present? It is a D block lemon. Okay, third group to 12th group, up to 3 to 12 is D block lemon. Okay, then scandium family, third group is scandium family because first element is scandium. Okay, in which period, that's the question, in which period the F block element starts for? In sixth period. Okay, what is the electron will enter in which orbital? 4 because n-2, 4 of orbital. Okay, I hope it's a interesting topic. I discussed that, you enjoyed a lot. Okay, we'll see you in next video. Thank you students. You watch the video carefully. I will arise the question from video also, and after watching the video you go through your book. Okay, both are you have to go through, then only you are able to answer all the question to get a full marks. Thank you student. Thank you.